A dream I know, deep up my feelings for you. Hello reality viewers, welcome back again to Reality Latest Gist, the home of news and politics. For this channel, we dey drop news every day and we dey react to every videos wey comes our way. And our reality news now we dey drop for this channel and we dey also dey talk am as it be. If today na the first time we be say you dey come across this channel, you are highly welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by. And if you are returning subscribers, I appreciate all of una for na massive support to this channel. I say may God bless all of una in Jesus name. Amen. I get video where I want present to una this very moment and I go to follow una, they watch the video. After we don't watch them together, make we drop our opinion constructively for the comment section. Like our videos and also share our videos if possible. Bye for now.
Dear Nigerians and gentlemen of the press, we in the opposition family welcome you again to the opposition house after a long while, as we set out again to hold the government accountable for the mismanagement of our country, its economy, security, and indeed every other facet. For over a year now, I have not spoken to you in my official capacity as the opposition coalition CUPP spokesperson. Well, we in the opposition family welcome you again to the opposition house after a long while, as we set out again to hold the government accountable for the mismanagement of our country, peace, economy, security, and indeed every other person. For over a year now, I have not spoken to you in my official capacity as the opposition coalition CUPP spokesperson. This was because I lost my voice while I was being held in illegal detention on the instigation of the APC government and the indicted Speaker of the House of Representatives, Femi Badjanamila, when we rejected their anti-people agenda. I lost absolute control of my voice cost. Some of both in Nigeria and abroad are in agreement that I must have come in contact with some very poisonous substance while in detention. I have visited several specialists who, by the special grace of God, have tirelessly worked on my throat and restored my voice to this extent. This is our first outing since that time, and I will continue to manage it until it gets fully restored. It feels good to be back. In 2015, Nigerians voted in President Muhammadu Buhari and the APC, believing that our economy would get stronger, insecurity and corruption wiped out. But 6.5 years after, the economy has totally collapsed and the lives of Nigerians are now so cheap that the government does not show empathy anymore. With every available data from the National Bureau and collaborated by ESPAC, Nigeria is now broke and fast sliding into a failed state. In 2015, the APC shouted to the high heavens that insurgents and terrorists had taken over and controlled large expanse and territories of Nigeria, up to the size of Belgium. But today, very hungry Nigerians are in shock that insurgents, bandits, terrorists, and kidnappers are now in firm control of Nigerian territory as large as Hungary. Hungary is at least 3 times the size of Belgium. The worst part is that the government is so confused and does not know what to do. These terrorists have advanced close even to the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, and are in firm control of almost all the entire local government areas in neighboring Niger State, and the government continues to thrive. All telecommunication signals have been cut off in the entire Zamfara State, and almost all of Kaduna. This has made it practically impossible for communities under attack to call for any help whatsoever, leading to the killing of entire villages and communities, which I discovered long after the bandits have left. Katsina State Government, which is the president's own home state, has lost total control of almost half of these 34 local government areas to these bandits. Niger State, which has common boundary with Abuja, has lost some local government areas. Sokoto State is also now under attack. It must be stated that these areas were very peaceful before the coming of APC and President Muhammadu Buhari. Most of the territories in the Northeast, which were also recovered before the 2015 election, which brought APC and Buhari to power, have also fallen back into the hands of the terrorists. The entire national security architecture has collapsed, and Nigeria is steadily losing the war, despite the trillions of naira spent by this government on security situation. Virtually all schools and educational institutions in many parts of northern Nigeria have been shut down, keeping our children uneducated in the shortest way to keep them poor, and also fastest way to make them possible recruit for these terrorist bandits. Farmers in Nigeria now find it extremely difficult, if not impossible, to go to their farms again, leading to the skyrocketing of prices on very basic food commodities. Yet, we have a president who, instead of admitting his failure, was blaming imaginary middlemen. Pure water is now 20 now, and middlemen also to be blamed. The 100% increase in price, this price has remained at 10 naira for almost 14 years. President Buhari does not even understand the problem facing the country. Hence, he does not have the solution or an idea of what the solution looks like. The bad policies, misapplication of funds, corruption and looting, and the lack of ideas and incompetence of President Muhammadu Buhari are responsible for the worsening economic situation of the country. Dear Nigeria, corruption is at a scale never contemplated or seen in our nation's history. Even during the most corrupt Abacha regime, unbridled corruption has become the order of the day in our public life. There is seemingly a race among officials of this APC government to know who would lose the vote. Almost all former office holders in our country who have pending criminal charges against them have all crossed over to the APC to have their sins against our country forgiven. It is on record that the APC has so played ping pong with the war against corruption, which it inherited in 2015, to the extent that to date no member of the APC who was a former office holder have been charged to court, including states like Zamfara, Imo, Osun, Nasarawa, which they are ravaged by their former governors who are members of their party. Again, it is on record that this APC government, despite their deceitful claims to Nigerians that they will fight corruption, has to date not successfully prosecuted any former office holder for corruption under their government. Nigerians can testify that there is no more public sector anti-corruption work being discussed anywhere. EFCC is now only chasing Yahoo Yahoo boys, yet our public officials daily line their pocket with our common patrimony without fear. There is a wise saying that says, "Show me your friends and I will show you who you are." Nigerians are please invited to see who the friends of President Muhammadu Buhari and the APC are. Their friends are the same persons who looted the country thrice, and who were charged for by the previous government, and those who are also currently looting the country thrice. The more you loot, the closer you are to the seat of power in Asoro, and the closer you get to President Muhammadu Buhari. There are now more public officials in APC who are billionaires than businessmen who are billionaires. The wars of Nigerian leaders are now in APC, and are regularly rewarded with party tickets for governorship and senatorial elections. What a shame. I repeat, what a shame. So much for the change mantra and triple promise of President Buhari, on which was elected in 2015. So much for the next-level agenda, on which Buhari returned himself to power in 2019. What a shame that citizens who voted President Buhari in 2015 and 2019, and who were able to feed themselves and their family, cannot even be sure of a single meal a day. As imperfect as our election was in 2015, and despite the supreme sacrifice many Nigerians have paid in our election, including new board members, women and children, it is on record that even to date, as the regime of President Buhari is gradually coming to an end, he has not made one single contribution to the improvement of the electoral process. In his first tenure, he refused to sign amendment to the Electoral Act solely for selfish electoral reasons. And even while the current controversy rages on the issue of electronic transmission of results being included in the Electoral Act and being demanded by the vast majority of Nigerians, the president has kept dishonorable silence while his party men, the APC, using their first majority, has insisted that Nigerians cannot see through the electoral process. What a shame for a party that won election from the opposition. That is why we were alarmed when we intercepted credible intelligence that the APC leaders have resolved as a first option to pray the 2023 general election by ensuring that the Electoral Act amendment process will not be completed before the 2023 general election. Or in the alternative, where the pressure from Nigerians is much, they will harmonize the bill, but they will never allow the electronic transmission of results. The information at our disposal includes the alleged late-night exchange of incentives to some members of the National Assembly in the Harmonization Committee to see to it that the electronic transmission of results does not see the light of the day. This is an insult on the sensibilities and sensitivities of Nigerian people. Noting that this process of Electoral Act amendment commenced since 2016 and has been completed 5 years after, they have agreed to drag this process and get up to their next year annual vacation, by which time, whereupon a claim that by the ECOWAS electoral treaty, laws cannot be amended less than 6 months to election. The process will terminate like they did for the 2019 election, but this time with possibility of throwing the country into a constitutional crisis. On electronic transition of results, we stand, and that position is immutable. Nigerians want it, INEC is ready for it, and has declared it has capacity for it. Yet APC wants to create our democracy and subject the activities of INEC, a constitutional independent body, to the political whims and caprices of Nigerian Telecommunication Commission and Mr. Issa Pantani, a man with questionable past. We want the National Assembly, members, that God in heaven will condemn them and humanity will condemn them if they doctor the Electoral Act amendment process and remove the electronic transmission of results, or if they refuse to complete this process within a reasonable time. It is clear from the foregoing that President Buhari has, over his past 6.5 years, emerged the most incompetent, inept, divisive, unskilled, unimpressive, uninspiring, and divisive president in our history. President Buhari lacks basic understanding of the issues in handling a multicultural, multi-ethnic, and multi-religious country such as Nigeria. His level of nepotism is second to none, and his narrow-mindedness is legendary. The current agitations and heightened insecurity in the Southeast, Southwest, South, and the Middle Belt are direct consequences of the failure of the president and his inability as well as incapacity to lead. The hate and sectionalism, nepotism, and divide and rule system with which the president has presided over this country since 2015 are the foundation of this agitation. Indeed, this government has failed, and it has failed woefully in all ramifications. However, more than the above fact that President Buhari is a failed leader is that the National Assembly is populated by political hallelujah boys who are approving and sanctioning everything from the executive. They are the laughingstock in the international community. We are by good Nigerians on notice that they will yet again approve the current loan request pending before them from the president. Even when the Nigerian debt burden is at its worst level ever, rising up to over 33 trillion, this National Assembly leadership will still approve the request for further borrowing. Even when the government cannot account to Nigerians on what this project, the money they claim to have been borrowed, where they are and what they have done, the National Assembly will still approve this one without asking questions. Nigeria's external loans have risen from 33% in 2015, and President Buhari, who is still borrowing today, does not have a credible repayment plan. Nigerians must know that for every 1,000 Naira Nigerians make today, 980 Naira is used for payment of debts. Which country can survive under such conditions? What a shame. Nigeria now spends more on debt servicing than on health and education. Due to the incompetence of the president, there has been an actual decline in the country's revenue. In 2020, the total revenue of the government was just about 3.4 trillion. Despite all the increases in the prices and cost of every government service, whereas in 2015, the total revenue of government was 5.43 trillion. Oil prices were higher in 2020 than it was in 2015, yet revenue was declining. Nigeria is suffering the cost and consequences of the incompetence of one man by name President Buhari and the corruption of a reckless political party, the APC. Clearly, President Buhari is running a morally economy that is 44 cities, 99 standing. We call on the opposition members in the National Assembly to work in alliance with patriotic members who are imprisoned in APC and seeking liberation to commence action and impeach the President of the Senate, Senator Ahmed Lawan, and the indicted Speaker of the House of Representatives, Mr. Femi Badjabiamila, immediately as a matter of national interest. Any further delay will occasion irreversible damage to the fabrics of our country. These two men have reduced the once respected parliament to house of political hallelujah that exists for the purpose of running errands for President Buhari and endorsing all his failed agenda. Never in the history of our parliament have the parliament elected such political plan. Both men have failed to guide their colleagues to act as checks and balances to the executive. Rather, both and their allies in the parliament are in a struggle on who will serve President Mohamed Buhari and APC more than they will serve Nigeria, and have proven beyond reasonable doubt that they do not well for Nigeria. Their interests are less than noble and patriotic, and it is best for Nigeria to stop them now before the destruction gets worse. When we resisted the emergence of Speaker Badjabiamila, we did that because we know that a man indicted for dishonest act in the U.S. cannot stand up to checkmate a regime that is acting in breach of the law. Every day Badjabiamila presides as Speaker, the parliament is ridiculed because it is a taboo for a man caught in dishonesty to be making law for honest people. Senate President Ahmed Lawan and indicted Speaker Badjabiamila have not only reduced but completely removed the power of the lawmaking process. Lawmakers are no longer respected and they are ignored even when they officially summon officials of the executive. When this mission of change in the leadership of the National Assembly is accomplished, the first duty of the new leadership will be to ensure the removal of President Mohamed Buhari from office immediately by way of impeachment before he completes his agenda of finally disintegrating and destroying our country. Let it be known that this action is as a matter of urgent national importance. The question is, we all have accepted the president and the leadership of the House led by Speaker Badjabiamila and Lawan has fed Nigeria. But the question is, are we going to keep quiet and wait until they finish destroying the country for the next remaining 19 months?
No.
Our children will answer that during the reign of this democratic tyrant, what did we do? Did we make an attempt or did we go to bed sleeping? Nigeria is tending towards irreversible damage if the National Assembly allows President Buhari to continue in office for the remaining 19 months of his tenure. There may not be a Nigeria for our children. Bandits and terrorists are emboldened by his crash failures to continue their onslaught on innocent Nigeria. If a cosmopolitan state like Kaduna, which houses over a dozen military and security formations, can collapse to the inferior firepower, manpower, and training of these motley ragtag bandits, then it clearly shows that this fish is rotten in the head. It is in view of this that the opposition, having come to the unassailable conclusion that President Buhari has abused his office, grossly misconducted himself, exhibited lack of capacity to remain in office, and failed in his primary duty as enshrined in Section 14 of the 1999 Constitution, which said that the security and welfare of the people is the primary purpose of government, and such failure renders the government useless to the people. The opposition has filed an action before the Federal High Court, seeking order of mandamus to compel the National Assembly to perform its constitutional duty and investigate the president over several accusations and allegations of gross misconduct and carry out their constitutional role and impeach President Buhari and his willing ally Osibanjo so that the nation can go for any election and start process. The APC government is a threat to the peace and unity of the country. Nigerians must reject them and reject them now as a matter of national interest. They must never come back again to power. These men are reckless. They must never come back again to power. Except we have all resigned to allowing them to destroy. as they represent everything that is a threat to the survival of one Nigeria. But we will not rest. Nigerians, we take back our country through lawful and democratic means. It has become all the more clearer that one can steal a presidential mandate but cannot steal the capacity to govern. Gentlemen of the press, all economic indices are worse than they were in 2015. Quality of education and health services are worse than they were in 2015. Corruption, insecurity, and impunity are worse than they were in 2015. The economy has shrunk. Debts have risen astronomically, while government clearly has not shown any sign that they know what they are up against. It is on this basis that the Nigerian opposition calls on the Nigerian media to stop being silent. We say, stop being neutral, as this country belongs to all of us. There will no separate Nigeria reserved for gentlemen of the press if we allow Buhari to destroy Nigeria due to his incompetence. Speak now, and we all will be refugees in our country when these criminal elements and bandits all over the country takes over. We also call on the civil society, workers' group, youth groups, market women, student bodies, and indeed all Nigerians to begin, in line with earlier meetings, mass mobilization for a citizens' national day of action. It has become imperative that citizens democratically express themselves in a civil process and say enough is enough, as posterity will inquire of what we all did to save the country when the rampaging regime was in power. Details of the action shall be made public in due course upon conclusion of all consultations. Citizens must join hands now to ensure a better society for us all. The job of salvaging Nigeria is not only job of the opposition. It is not only opposition members that they kidnap from Kaduna Expressway, or they kill in the southeast, or in the southwest, or in the northeast. Every citizen must get involved. Every citizen who has lost a loved one due to the insecurity in the land. Every citizen who cannot feed his family due to the dwindling economy. Every citizen who cannot get basic government services, including health care and education, due to the corruption in this government. Every citizen who has one sorrowful tale or the other to the incompetence of the APC must come out now. Under the watch of President Buhari and APC, Nigeria has become the poverty capital of the world. Under the watch of President Buhari and APC, Nigeria has become the unemployment capital of West Africa, with over one-third of its workforce out of job. Under the watch of President Buhari and APC, Nigeria infamously remains as the third most terrorized country in the world, even worse than war-torn countries, taking us back to the Stone Age, when life was nasty, brutish, and short. Under the watch of President Buhari and APC, Nigeria became the world capital of open defecation, sending the country back to the Stone Age. Should it get worse before we speak? Finally, we thank God for healing and believe that we will continue to get better. We also thank Nigerians who have been praising the suffering and hardship imposed on them by President Buhari and APC for keeping the peace. We urge them to ignore the movement of politicians from other parties to the APC, as those are not in their interest. Politicians who believe they have not made money since their election are moving to the APC so they can steal money, and those who are stolen are running into the APC to get cover, as the APC is the platform where looters are given national honors and not prosecuted, and even invited into the state house to have handshake with their leader, President Muhammadu Buhari. Many of them have seen that at the rate the country is declining, it will not take long before it collapses. Hence, many of them need to grab whatever they can for themselves and their family so they can get out if the engine of the country stops. We also thank men of the Nigerian security forces who have built a wall of defense around us to defend what they can within the available resources. When the opposition takes over, God's willing, their lot will improve and they can even be sure of having to spend time with their own families. The ongoing reorganization in the opposition family and the political parties in this alliance, especially the PDP, offers strong hope for our country. A new and appealing crusade will soon be launched, which most Nigerians will buy into once these internal issues are resolved with the opposition family. When the opposition takes over in 2023 with support and support of Nigerian people, we will be coming to heal a broken nation. We will be coming to unite Nigeria, repair the economy, and make it once again a viable and growing economy. We will be coming to secure our country and set a new agenda. We will be coming to restore and build a nation where peace and justice shall reign. We will be coming to build a country all ethnic groups will believe in and work for its progress. Nigerians should have faith, continue to register and collect their PVs, so that by the ballot, we will chase these political invaders away. The time of the locust will soon be over. We call on members of the opposition families to stand firm. All those in the parliament, in party leadership, and in all walks of life, Nigerians are firmly behind us, only bidding their time to lawfully vote the opposition as their government, to lawfully vote in opposition, as this government has failed woefully. This is the reason why President Muhammadu Buhari and the APC do not want electronic transfer of election results, and the reason why we must insist on it. And for the last time, let us say it clearly, that the problem why President Muhammadu Buhari got away with all his divisive and destructive activity is because the parliament that has the constitutional responsibility to checkmate such a rampaging democratic tyrant have failed in their duty. Because we elected Ahmed Lawan and indicted Speaker Femi Badamela, who does not have the capacity to lead a modern day parliament, who are only interested in rushing to the villa and being as the president desire. Until the Nigerian people join us in mounting pressure for a responsive parliament, once there is a responsive parliament in place, the president can be put on check. But while we are doing that, we are taking the legal path. That is why we went to the Federal High Court this morning to ask the Federal High Court to compare the National Assembly to exercise their constitutional duty of checks and balances by commencing the process of investigating the president for gross misconduct and impeaching him. Let Nigerians understand the reason behind it. The standard President Muhammadu Buhari has given to us is not the standard of national governance. So if we keep quiet, it means that the next president that will come will use that as a standard. So that is why, whether we will succeed or not is not the question. Because children that is yet on Bromo ask us, when we had this kind of situation, what did we do? Did we go to sleep because the deep president is too powerful and people fear him? No. We pay with taxpayers' money. Remember, he used to be on pension. Now he can afford friends who can give his children the iPad for wedding. So for the part that is running on public funds, for the part that is running on your part, on your time, you have a right to demand for better government. And let the world know that the standard of what APC is doing and Buhari is not the standard of national governance. And that the APC have brought so much political recklessness that can destroy and undermine.